We have Greetings. The Lord be with you.
Who are you?
Do not be afraid, for you have found favor with God. You will be with child, and you will call his name Jesus.
How can this be? I am only a virgin.
The Holy Spirit will come upon you and overshadow you, and the one to be born will be called the Son of God. Even your relative Elizabeth is having a child in her old age. Nothing is impossible with God.
I am the Lord's servant. You may go in peace.
Oh, dear Mary, come in.
Come in, Elizabeth.
Goodbye, Elizabeth. Goodbye.
Oh, hello, Mary.
Oh, hello, Joseph.
Where have you been all these months?
I was visiting my cousin, Elizabeth.
Mary, are you with child?
Yes, I am. You see, an angel came to me and told me I would have the Savior of the
no,
world.
No, that's impossible.
Nothing is impossible with God.
I'm sorry, Mary. I'm going to have to divorce you.
Dear Lord, how could Mary do this to me? Please show me the way.
Amen.
How could Mary do such a thing? How could she?
Joseph, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, For what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and he will save his people from their sins.
Thank you, Lord.
Mary! Mary! I've never said it like sorry! I believe now. An angel came to me last night, and he told me the truth. I believe now. I'm so relieved. Now let's go get married and start our journey for the census.
Joseph, where are we going?
To Bethlehem.
Shelter over there. Go.
King of Judah, don't you forget.
Here you go.
Now leave, wife, leave.
As you wish.
Your Majesty, you have a visitor from the East.
Whatever.
Hello, Your Majesty. I have bring good.
Kiss my ring.
I don't. Rings all.
Then kiss my toe.
I kiss your rings.
Now, what do you want?
I've come to ask you an opinion. I'm going to give gifts to the newborn king, and I have gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
What new king? I am the king of Judah. Those gifts are only good for real kings, like me, not for babies.
So why don't you give them to me?
No, it's okay. I will bring them anyway. Goodbye.
Wait, before you leave, when you find this new king, you tell me and I will go and worship him too.
Of course, my king. Good day.
Now when I go worship him, I'll just kill him.
Do not be afraid. I bring you tidings of great joy that will be for all people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born unto you.
Yes, we will go worship. Let's go.
Mary, I'm going to get wood for the fire. Don't worry.
You stay safe. Is this the Messiah?
Yes, it is.
Let me down.
Thank you. He will be the greatest king of all peoples.
Excuse me, is this baby Jesus?
Yes, it is.
The Messiah.
Oh, Messiah! I have brought great gifts for him. Firstly, myrrh. Secondly, frankincense.
Go to sleep, Mary. Keep the baby warm.
Of course.
Get up! Take the child and his mother and flee to Egypt, for Herod is coming, and he wants to kill your son.
Mary! Mary! We have to leave! An angel came to me last night and told me we have to leave to Egypt because Herod wants to kill baby Jesus.
Let's go!
Thank you, Renee and Aaron, for doing worship for us again today. And those were lovely Christmas carols that we sang together. Tonight I want to talk about Emmanuel, God with us. In Matthew chapter 1, verse 23, which cross-references Isaiah chapter 7, verse 14, it says, "Behold, the virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel," which is translated God with us. The Isaiah portion of scripture says, "Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel." Thanks be to God that we enjoy the very presence of God among us and in us. God is with us all. It's the meaning of the biblical name, the Emmanuel, God with us. The knowledge of the name should impact our lives to be great joy, give us great joy, for the presence of God is with us. I want to talk today about the following, about the definition of the name Emmanuel and what that implies to us. First of all, it implies his presence is in the world, that God is omnipresent, that God is everywhere, that there's no place on earth where he cannot be found. If you seek him with all your heart, you will find him. He is Emmanuel. He is everywhere. In 1 Kings chapter 8, verse 27, it says, "But will God indeed indwell on the earth? Behold, heaven and the heaven of heavens cannot contain you. How much less this temple which I have built." Jesus came. And he came to live among us and to dwell among us. But the fact is that when Jesus left, he said, "I will send a comforter to live with you." And so we have that Holy Spirit. In John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." That God is present in all of creation. Romans 8:21 says, "Because of the creation itself also will be delivered from the bondage of corruption in the glorious liberty of the children of God." When God comes and dwells with us finally, after this earth has passed away, but we dwell with him and a new earth is created, we will dwell in the presence of him who will recreate all of creation. In Matthew 1, verse 21, and says, "And she shall bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." So what is Jesus, which the Hebrew word would be Yeshua, which is really Joshua, is how we say that word. It means the Lord saves. What's he saved from? He saves us from our past sins. He saves us from our present ones. And he saves us from a future of damnation. Although we celebrate the coming of the King, and we celebrate that Jesus is with us, Satan is prowling around like a roaring lion, the Bible says, seeking whom he may devour. John chapter 12, verse 31 says, "Now is the judgment of this world. Now the ruler of this world will be cast out." And then Ephesians 2:2 says, "In which you once walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of power of the air, the spirit who now works in the sons of disobedience." What is going to happen is when Jesus lives in our heart, we go from disobedience to obedience. And even though Satan is prince, God is still in control. God did not give Satan that title. God did not declare him prince. In fact, we gave him the title when we gave ourselves over to him, when we decided to disobey. As prince, he has great influence over us. He deceives, he misguides, he divides families and churches. But let me tell you that the presence of God is with the believers. And if we rely on the presence of God in our lives, we do not have to worry about the deceiving power of the enemy. His presence is in the believer. Matthew 28:20, "Teaching them always to observe all things I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the age." Joel 2:27, "Then you shall know that I am in the midst of Israel. I am the Lord your God, and there is no other. My people shall never be put to shame." And Joel 3:16-17, "The Lord also will roar from Zion and utter his voice from Jerusalem. The heavens and the earth will shake, But the Lord will be a shelter for his people and the strength of his children of Israel, the strength of the children of Israel. So you shall know that I am the Lord your God, dwelling in Zion, my holy mountain, and Jerusalem shall be holy, and no alien shall ever pass through her again. God is so awesome that he promised to be with us, and his presence does many things to us. Because God is Emmanuel, God with us, his presence does many things. It encourages us, according to Joshua 1:6, which says, be strong and of good courage. Or another version says, be strong and courageous. For to this people you shall divide as an inheritance the land which I swore to their fathers to give to them. And so if you are feeling discouraged today, I want to encourage you that God is your encourager. That God is the same God that said this to Joshua, be strong and courageous. Not only that, but God comforts. John chapter 14, verses 16 to 18 says, and I'll pray the Father, and he will give you another helper or comforter, another version says, that he may abide with you forever. The Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. But you know him, for he dwells with you and will be in you. I will not leave you as orphans. I will come to you. So God comforts. I don't know what you're going through. I know there's plenty of bad times happening around the world. We've lost loved ones, I myself included. We've been through hardships. This COVID is just taking a licking on us. But God is there to comfort. But God is also there to strengthen. Joel 3:16 says, the Lord also will roar from Zion and utter his voice from Jerusalem. The heavens and earth will shake, but the Lord will be a shelter for his people and the strength of the children of Israel. So no matter what's happening around you, when God is Emmanuel, God with us, he strengthens us and he protects us. Jeremiah 15, verse 20 says he protects us. And I will make you to this people a fortified bronze wall, and they will fight against you, and they shall not prevail against you, for I am with you. I will save you and deliver you, says the Lord. He protects and he guides in times of darkness. Exodus 13:21 says, and the Lord went before them by day in a pillar of cloud to lead the way, and by night a pillar of fire to give them light so as to go by the day. We follow God. What are you following today? Who are you following today? Can I ask you to turn your eyes on Jesus? Turn your eyes on him who wants to lead you by the Spirit of God that lives within you. 2 Samuel 22:29 says, for you are my lamp, O Lord. The Lord shall enlighten my darkness. Not only is God the God who guides in time of darkness, but he also provides. As Emmanuel, he provides for us. Psalms 113:6-9 says, who humbles himself to behold the things that are in the heavens and in the earth. He raises the poor out of dust and lifts the needy out of the ash heap, that he may seat him with princes, the princes of his people. He grants the barren woman a home and the joyful mother children. And he also heals. Jeremiah 8:22 says, is there no balm in Gilead? Is there no physician there? Why then is there no recovery? For the health of the daughter of my people. He is the balm of Gilead. The fact that Jesus is with us and came as Emmanuel also shows that he is divine, that he is God with us, that God's Spirit that we know through the person of Jesus lives within us. And God chooses to reveal himself through Jesus. The Bible says in John 1:14 that the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we see his glory full of grace and truth. Now, I don't want us to conflate what the Word of God, which we refer to as the Bible, and the Word in Jesus as being the same thing. Jesus is not a personified form of Scripture. He is a personified form of what is spoken by God. If you go through Scripture, and I believe Scripture is divinely inspired, but you see Satan's words in there, so is Jesus also Satan's words? Of course not. Jesus are the words spoken by the Father, the promises, the yeses and the amens. And so God chose to reveal himself through Jesus. And God chose to reveal himself through Jesus so that we could come to know him. And so this Christmas Eve, as we're celebrating the advent of Jesus Christ, the coming of the Christ child, I want you to remember that God came, dwelt among us so that we could know him better and that we are no longer separated from him. What are you going to do with Jesus today? Are you going to follow him? Are you going to allow him to lead you wherever he wants to go and he wants you to go? Or are you going to do something else? Ponder in your heart today. Let's pray. Father, I pray for all my friends that are watching this today. I pray that you would just be with them, that you would encourage them greatly, that you would show yourselves as Emmanuel to them, that God is with them in times of trouble, in times of happiness, of times of joy, of times of sorrow. God, may you be with them now. May your blessing rest upon them. In the name of Jesus Christ, we ask this. Amen and amen. God bless you. I'll see you on Sunday, 10 a.m., the same website. God bless you. Have a great day.